Hi everyone. Welcome to Laura's View and Tarot 2. I'm really glad you're here. I'm glad I'm here. Oh, I was stuck indoors for a couple of days because we had snow up to my waist and it finally got cleared and I did my little part of that and here we are. Today's date is Tuesday, December 13th, 2022. And in this video, once I get down to business, I wanted to talk about some upcoming legal matters that alt media is saying are going to happen in 2023. Let me show you a short video that I saw on another location. You'll have to pause the video if you want to get a closer look because I won't be able to put up a direct link. One of my viewers, Laureen, sent me this link, not knowing I had already seen it on my own. And what's interesting here is there is apparently a construction company erecting buildings in Nuremberg, Germany right now. And that is where apparently legal processes are being moved for 2023 for some of those events. Now, if you go to this site, look at this video, it's short. It talks about how the letter 17, you know what I mean when I say letter 17, shows up both in the construction company and in the signage. And he was thinking, the poster was thinking possibly there was something to do with a communication in that, a code. But I really liked his comment here. He said, and his name, his online name, I think I can say that is Maori Morpheus. And he mentioned that Dr. Reimer Fulmich started the Nuremberg tribunals in Poland last year, but the deep state Polish government shut them down and sent the troops to support the Nazi Azov battalion in Ukraine. So they're setting them up all over the world and they're starting in the home of tribunals, Nuremberg. Now, when those were attempted in Poland earlier, no, it was last year. The only reason they called them Nuremberg 2.0 was just kind of to honor the intent of the original Nuremberg trials, which was to call to account those people that had committed medical crimes. And so you can kind of guess the focus of the Dr. Fulmich's inquiries and how he was getting evidence and gathering affidavits and what have you, and hoping to pursue with some indictments and trials at some point. So I would just like to take a minute and ask the universe tonight. The construction site shown here in Nuremberg, Germany, is this going to be the site? Oh, no, I don't want to get into, I don't want to say it that way. Because if this just ends up being so, let's change it a little bit. Sorry, I'm thinking out loud as I go here because I try to craft a question that the universe can answer and answer in a way that's heartening. So the alt media chatter of Nuremberg 2.0 and that at some point those events are going to happen worldwide is Nuremberg one of the places that these events will happen? And is there other information the universe wants us to know about legal matters involving medical issues? Okay, let's see what the universe has to say. So the alt media chatter about Nuremberg 2.0, we're looking for insights and information and possibly confirmation that 2023 is the year that we will begin seeing those events unfold more publicly. And other information the universe wants us to know. Our first card, Ace of Wands. So yes, Nuremberg is going to be home with some of those. Four of Swords. Six of Cups. The Star. Seven of Wands, The Hanged Man, Lovers. We have an ace, and three of our seven cards are major arcanas. This is an important topic. So our question was, is the alt media chatter that Nuremberg 2.0 type of legal matters will be conducted in 2023 true? And was there other insights? And possibly is Nuremberg the site of one of those events? We're getting a yes with that. And I think that's to both aspects of that one question, that Nuremberg is, there are facilities being built there to do some of these type of events. I have to be careful how I phrase things, remember that, okay? And that they are going to happen in general. Now, swords are always about written and spoken words, and legal matters definitely involve swords, okay? So with the Four of Swords though, we're getting told that it's not gonna happen immediately. So it won't be early in 2023 that we see this. And there's going to be, as always, some information that's withheld from the public that happens behind closed doors, depositions, what have you. But we're getting reassured here. Let's look at our recent past, okay? The focus of these is going to be on our children, okay? And damage that's been done to them. This is a card of reconciliation, and this is part of the process that the earth needs to heal. As we acknowledge some deep, deep wrongs, correct them to the fullest extent of our ability, and safeguard the well-being of our little ones from here on out. We have the Star showing up in the present card. That's kind of cool because the Star card, first of all, is just a very pure energy. Often it talks about some off-world influence, and certainly we can use some getting our earth back on path and our DNA restored and all the things that we need to have to take our place in the cosmos as we should. Now, the another aspect of the Star card is that it's moving in the right direction. So yeah, we're getting a yes, and we are moving in the right direction. I think we're going to find that our hopes for some justice and accountability, that those efforts are blessed and move forward without too much in the way of issues. Now, again, as we know, this card is high ground, facing a challenge, and determination, okay? So yeah, bringing individuals to account for knowingly doing wrong. Yeah, there's just no backing down from it. They are determined, and we've got the high ground here. and the accountability piece is just, there's just no way around it. The Hanged Man shows up here. That's kind of interesting for one of our main advice card, because the Hanged Man, besides looking at things in a new perspective, it's also a card that shows an opportunity for inner peace. And I think that's just beautiful, because we have to, people or beings that have committed crimes against humanity, they need to be held accounting for them. And it is through that process of facing judgment and justice that we are going to find some peace and move forward, because especially as our beloved normies begin to wake up and realize some of the things that have been done to our little ones, we know that's a really, really tough red pill to swallow. Really tough, okay? And but this will all be part of the healing that our earth needs to move forward. We're having the Lovers card here show up as a little further advice, not our main advice, but further advice. And the Lovers card talks about, it's a loving card, so there's a lot of loving energy showing up in this basic read. Even though we're asking about legal matters, we're getting told that it needs to be done. And it's we're going to be very happy with the process as it unfolds, okay? There's a alignment with the universe and with our objectives here that's going to be blessed and help us move forward. Let's see if there's some other insights about the subject of legal matters involving those actions. We have Queen of Wands showing up. Okay, she's a accomplishment card and very, very just and fair, brutally honest, and truth is what we need to get to have people held accountable accurately for things that they've done. Then the King of Pentacles shows up. He's a faithful provider, okay, and generosity. And yeah, we're going to benefit from this process going forward. It's going to help us, speaking of going forward, to go forward and enjoy a healthier, brighter tomorrow than we've had in the past. Okay, coming to the end of an era with the 10 of Swords. So the days of these crimes not being addressed is coming to an end. And again, as we move forward in our new path, we're not going to be looking with any longing. If we're remotely kind-hearted and loving, we're not going to be looking back with any longing to go back to draconian measures, forced remedies, things like that. Those are going to be a thing of the past. And thank goodness for that. So according to the card reads, yes, those events are going to unfold in 2023 or begin, maybe not early in 2023, but they are going to start. And the first point of accountability seems like it's going to be for medical crimes. And then as time goes on, other crimes against humanity hopefully will come to people's attention and we can get some closure there. So it's looking good, guys. It really is. We've got to remember that the war may be done, but there's still some battles to be fought, some skirmishes. And as always, as evil bids their adieu to this plane of existence, they are going to do whatever rearguard actions they can, just because that's what they are. They're evil. They don't go quietly into that good night, but by golly, they're going. Okay, we've got this. So in the meantime, let's picture the world we want with people that have committed crimes, held accountable for them, justice being served, and being served in legal, lawful ways, not by vigilante justice, things like that, but with the ways we've got set up for us. Now, I know we have to talk tribunals because we need a lot of cleanup in our civilian courts, and that's why these are going to be the first and best avenue for justice for us. So let's wish those who have seats on tribunals currently will have just to have wisdom and provide the best possible outcome for everyone involved. I always pull back on that because you can't go wrong with that. That's it for this video. Thank you so much. I appreciate the time you give me. I try not to waste it. And for those of you that are new subscribers, I welcome you to my channel. If you're a resubscriber, I welcome you back. You know, that has to happen. Sometimes it's just the way it is. And for those that you support me some way, I do thank you for your gifts and generosity very, very much. Okay. Most of what I get for doing this is ad revenue, and that's fine. But some of you also go out of your way to do super thanks or buy me a coffee, and I appreciate that too. Please don't do it if you can't afford to do it. No matter how much you appreciate what I do, make sure you can afford it. Okay. All right. So you don't hear that often on YouTube, do you? But remember, I'm not a teenager anymore. And my whole goal here is to eventually face our loving creator and have him say, well finished. Because I've screwed up my life a lot when I was younger. And I don't claim I didn't. Okay. So my goal is to hear well finished. And part of that is not taking advantage of people. So that's just how I'm doing business here. Thank you so much. Good night.